Let us do the rate analysis for the next item of work, that is first class brickwork in cement mortar 1:6 for superstructure. So starting with the material calculation, let us assume a volume of 10 meter cube. So now we have to find the quantity of bricks. To find the quantity of bricks, that will be found out by dividing the volume to the size of the brick. So let us assume the standard size of the brick as 20 by 10 by 10 centimeter. While writing here, we had to write this value in terms of meter. So let us divide all these three values with 100. On dividing, we will get 0.2 by 0.1 into 0.1. So this gives you the volume of one brick. So on dividing the volume which is considered to the volume of one brick, we will get the number of bricks which is equal to 5000 numbers. So now let us find the volume of bricks. So the volume of bricks will be found out by multiplying the number of bricks with the volume of one brick. So the number of bricks what we have got is 5000 numbers into volume of one brick. Here while considering the volume, we had to take the nominal size of the brick. And we know that the nominal size of the brick is 19 by 9 by 9 centimeter. This size is the standard size, which includes the mortar thickness also, but the nominal size does not include the mortar. Here, on converting the centimeter in terms of meter, we will get the size of the brick as 0.19 into 0.09 into 0.09. So this gives you the volume of one brick. On multiplying one brick volume with the numbers, we will get the total volume of the brick, which is 7.695 meter cube. Now, let us find the volume of mortar. To find the volume of mortar, we will have to subtract the total volume what we have considered in the earlier with the volume of total number of bricks. So the total volume is 10 meter cube minus of volume of bricks, that is 7.695. So on subtracting these two values, we will get a value of 2.305 meter cube. Then this gives you the wet volume of the mortar, but we had to find the dry volume. So to find the dry volume will be always 1.54 times greater than the wet volume. So hence, for that reason, we will be multiplying the wet volume with 1.54. On multiplying these two values, we will get 3.549 meter cube. So this gives you the dry volume of mortar. Once the dry volume of mortar is known to you, let us find the quantities of the material. The mortar consists of both cement as well as sand. We will first find out the quantity of the cement. To find the quantity of the cement, we have to take the total dry volume, which is 3.549 divided by proportion. Here the mortar proportion which is given in the question is 1:6. Hence you have to sum the proportion, that is 1 plus 6 into 1. Here 1 represents the part of the cement and 6 represents the part of the sand. While finding the quantity of cement, we have to multiply with the part of the cement, which is 1. Now on simplifying the whole thing, you will get a quantity of 0.507 meter cube. On multiplying this with 30 number of bags, we will get the total number of bags as 15.21, approximately take 15 number of bags. So the total, it requires 15 number of bags for 10 meter cube of volume. Then, let us find the quantity of sand. To find the quantity of sand, we had to take the dry volume of mortar, which is 3.549. divided by sum of the proportion, that is 1 plus 6 into the part of the sand. In this proportion, the part of the sand is 6. Hence, multiply this with 6. On simplifying this, you will get a value of 3.042 meter cube. Approximately, you take the value as 3 meter cube. So, this completes the material calculation. Now, let us draw the table for the rate analysis. The table should consist of serial number, particulars, quantity, rate as well as amount. Again, the table will be divided into three parts. One is the material quantity, then the labor quantity, and then the contingency quantity. So in the material quantity, as we are doing for the first class BBM, the quantities or the materials which are required are bricks, sand, cement, as well as scaffolding and ropes for the construction of superstructure. So here, the quantity of the material we have found in the earlier step. So let us write those quantities here. We have got 5000 number of bricks and 3 cubic meter of sand and 15 bags of cement. And the rate for those materials are For brick, the rate is 6 rupees per number. For sand, the rate is 1300 per meter cube. For cement, the rate is 330 rupees per bag. Then, on multiplying quantity with rate, we will get the amount of that particular item. 5000 into 6 gives you 30,000. 3 into 1300 gives you 3900. 15 into 330 gives you 4950 rupees. Then for the scaffolding and the ropes, we have to assume the lump sum charge here. Let us consider the lump sum amount of 220 rupees for the scaffolding as well as the ropes. So that gives you the material amount. Coming to the labor amount, in the labor, the type of labor required are head mason, mason, and then mazdoor. Here, half number of head mason is required. That means only a half a day head mason will visit the site. And totally 9 numbers of mason will be required and 20 numbers of mazdoor are required. The rate which are fixed for those labors are 400 per day, 390 per day and 290 rupees per day. Then on multiplying these two columns, we will get all these amounts. Then at the end, for the contingency and the transportation charges, we will assume the lump sum amount of 200 rupees. So after finding all the amounts, we had to add all the amounts at the end. Let us add all these values. On adding all these values, you will get a total amount of 48,780 rupees. After getting the total amount, we had to add 1% of the water charges for that total amount. So let us do the 1% of this. The 1% of this amount gives you a value of 487 rupees 80 paise. So then you add these two amounts. On adding these two amounts, you will get the new total amount of 49,267 rupees 80 paise. Then for this new amount, we will be adding the 10% profit charges and the overhead charges. So again, you have to find 10% of this. 10% of this amount gives you an amount of 4,926 rupees 78 paise. Finally, you have to add these two amounts. On adding these two things, you will get a grand total of amount 54,194 rupees 58 paise. That means, for 10 cubic meter of volume, for constructing a BBM work for 10 cubic meter of volume, it hardly requires an amount of 50,000 rupees, 54,194 rupees. If you want to find the BBM for 1 cubic meter of volume, then what will be the rate? For finding that, we had to divide the total amount with 10. On dividing, you will get 5,119 rupees 0.54. Approximately, take the value as 5,420 rupees. That means if you want to construct a first class brick masonry of any proportion, it may be 1:6 or 1:3, whatever the proportion of the cement mortar it may be. If you want to construct a first class brickwork masonry for 10 meter cube or for 1 meter cube, the amount will be either 54,194 rupees for 10 meter cube or 5,420 rupees for 1 meter cube. So the procedure for finding the first class brickwork masonry of any proportion, whatever the cement mortar proportion it will be given in the question paper, but the procedure will be as it is. Only the material calculation will vary because the material calculation will be depending on the proportion. Only the material of cement and sand will vary because here only we are going to use the proportion of the cement mortar. Apart from that, the brick calculation will remain as it is and the table will be remain as it is. So you follow the same procedure for the first class brickwork for superstructure in the first floor or ground floor, whatever it may be. So this completes the fourth item of work.